inspired by a dream.
Al norte.
Al norte.
They traveled thousands of miles to get to a new land.
It's very, very sad. And it's not just a new thing. It's happened even before in our history. In the 1930s, they deported almost 2 million people illegally, most of whom were citizens because they were Mexican. And this was the Hoover administration trying to create real jobs for real Americans, which didn't include Latinos, okay? And they deported 2 million people. And one of them was my grandfather. And my family was broken apart. And my grandmother had to raise 7 children without a husband. And one of them died. And my father had to be raised without a father. I never met my Mexican grandfather as a result of all that. And the pain of this still affects our family to this day. So when I see these people, families being broken apart at the border, I know that this pain will continue for many generations, you know? And that's why 35 years ago when I saw the faces, because I was raised on the border, trying to cross in for a better life, I was passionate about making El Norte, because I felt if I could give a heart and a soul to the refugees and the immigrants, that the demonization of immigrants would end. And it had impact when it was originally released. It helped create an atmosphere in which the United States, 2 years after we released El Norte, gave protected status to refugees, and it saved thousands of lives. So I know that the message of El Norte is strong, and it's needed once again today, and that's why it's coming back into theaters.
The dream still lives in a land called El Norte.